Mistake that most of you do is you go and live in these places. They charge you in dollars, $2,000, $3,000 a monthly.
Okay, welcome to my channel once again. I came to check a client's land in this area, and I had something in my mind that I wanted to share with you. You know, a lot of African Americans come to Ghana and come to Africa basically, and they don't know certain things that they should expect, although they make their research and all that. But I just want to share with you these 6 points that I have. African Americans, if you come to Africa, things that you should know. Yes, so as I'm going, I'm walking with you through this new site. I'll be talking to you about 6 things that you need to know before moving to Africa. Yes, so let's go and move with me. I'll be showing you stuff that is going on in the site. I just came to check a client's land here, and I decided to do this video. So let's go. Don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to like, don't forget to share. Thank you. This seems construction is going on. We are working on a project. Yes, this is what is going on, as you can see. Okay, so my first point that I'm going to give you is going to be is when you decide to come to Africa and live here and stay here with us, I will tell you, please think of creating your own job when you are moving to Africa, because Africa that you see has a lot of graduates that are unemployed, a lot of them, and every year we churn out lots of graduates that do not even know where to get a job to do. So for me, if you are an African American or from the diaspora and you want to move to Africa and work, one advice that I will give you is to create your own job. You know, there are a lot of things that you might be doing, whether in the UK, Europe or US, that is not really a big thing here. So perhaps you have a lot of competitors out there. I will advise you to bring that thing here, that particular job here, and trust me, you will have lots of people who establish yourself, and I'm sure you have a lot of people who will be interested in your service. A lot of people who will be interested in your service, honestly, because I've actually seen lots of people coming here with their own set up everything here, and they are working from home, and they are working, they've set up their businesses and they are flourishing. I will advise you do something like that, so that you will not find yourself wanting when you move here. There are some people who have moved here without any planning, good planning and all that, and they just fall out and they go back, and they are like, and they start complaining about this place. Prepare very well before moving to Africa. Yes, that's one advice that I'm going to give you. Prepare, and when you are coming, create your own jobs. Create your own jobs. Yes, my second point is going to be when you're coming to Africa and you are looking for a place to stay or to live, one thing that I will tell you to do is to try, especially if you are here to connect with the people,
I will advise you to try and look for places that are like closer to the community, closer to the community that you can do what, mingle yourself up with the community, with the locals, so that you get to understand how the community or how the people think and how the community works itself. Because truth be told, if you are coming to a place, to Africa for instance, and you are or you decide to live in, let's say for instance in Ghana, you'll decide to live in East Legon, you decide to live in Trasako, you decide to live in, these places are like our luxurious or our plush places that they live, or let me say the rich lives, you know. We have these places, and for me, I will not advise you to live in such places, because these places, people live there and it's like America, kind of like America sort of, because everybody gets up and they go to their workplace, whatever they are doing. Their houses that they live in is fenced, and it's them and their family, or their, like, you don't get to communicate, you don't get to talk to people. And when it comes to certain things or certain traditions in the country or with the culture itself, you cannot get it at these places. You cannot get it at these places. I think this is a nice building. It's inside, so you can't see it properly, but I think it's a nice building. Yes, very simple. Yes. So that's one thing I will tell you, because live within the communities. And you know, one mistake that most of you do is you go and live in these places, they charge you in dollars, $2,000-$3,000 a monthly, and you start complaining and you are like, oh, it's similar to what we have in America or what we have in the UK and all that. And I, one thing that I want to say is, hey, I understand all these complaints, but for me, I will say you don't really make or do a proper research, because if you really do the proper research, you will get to know that in Ghana, with this $2,000, if I'm doing a rough calculation with you, with the $2,000 and $3,000 monthly that you are supposed to pay for perhaps a studio apartment, when we are converting these $2,000 into Ghana cities, that will be like, right now it will be like times 12 times 12 times 11 times 12, like, yeah, times 11 or times 12, and that should be 5 will give you 10,000 Ghana cedis, or 20,000, so meaning 22,000 Ghana cedis. Let me tell you something, there are places in Ghana that you can rent 2 years advance and you are going to pay 9,000 Ghana cedis. Very nice, they have their washroom. We normally call it chamber and hall, but it's like a one bedroom self-contained. So you have your hall, your living area, you have your bedroom, you have your kitchen, and you have your toilet and bath. You see, and these places, maximum 9,000 Ghana cedis, or let's say 10,000 Ghana cedis for 2 years. It is not furnished. Yes, I understand, it is not furnished. So what you can do is, the remaining amount of money that you have, that's the 12,000 Ghana cedis, honestly, you can add up something to rent, to buy your sofas, to buy your bed, your TV, your everything, and furnish the place, your air condition, everything, and furnish the place. And you have this place for yourself 2 years. So for instance, if you are living in Ghana and you are going to live here for like 2 years, 3 years, the next thing that you are just going to do is just pay your rent, and that's all. Why do you people worry yourself with East Legon and this studio apartment, and you pay, and renting these type of apartments, you are going to have the privilege to be with the locals, learn a lot from them, because these East Legon, Trasako areas, what are you getting from? Everyone is just busy doing their own thing. Everybody's just busy doing their own thing. So my question is, why worry yourself on this? Why worry yourself on this? Why worry yourself on this? I don't know why many of you come and you complain and you complain and you complain and you complain. Trust me, these places are very affordable, that you can rent it out, live the way you want to live, and also have the opportunity to learn a lot from the people, because mostly the people that live in these areas are Ghanaians and are the local people, and you can make friends, start learning some one or two things from them. Some are married people, some are, you can even get doctors, nurses living in the same like compound or something. So hey, my advice will surely and will definitely be, try living within the communities. Try living within the communities. And also, my next point is going to be, or my third point is going to be, you're respecting the culture of wherever you go in Africa. Because hey, I understand you are coming from America, different cultures that you've experienced, and here is Africa. Try to respect the culture, and also do what, make sure you have, just learn what you don't know. There are certain things that you don't know, and I will just advise you to learn from them. Just learn something. It's very important. It's very, very important. I think this house is cool. It's far away a bit, but I think it's cool. Yeah. Just learn something from these people. And I'm sure by the time you move away from this same area, and perhaps you get in your own land and building your own house, you will understand the people. You will get to understand the people. Yes, so respect the culture, the food, everything that they do, their lifestyle, respect it. Don't be like, hey, what is this? What kind of food is this? What kind of... Stop that. I will advise you to stop that. It's very, very important. Yes, so as I'm walking you through, I'm just showing you around. Also, you see children playing. It's just free. Peace. These are the areas. You see people. And this is like a new site. And this brings me to my next point. When you look at the road that I'm walking on right now, it's not hard. It's a rough road. This is a rough road. Mostly you see this type of roads in Ghana, especially new sites, because people just buy land in places and they start developing, and it will take time for the government to do what to realize that this place is developed, lots of people are living here, so we should come in and do what, construct the road. So you are going to see these type of roads a lot, I mean a lot. You are going to see these type of roads a lot in Ghana, especially in the new sites. We have bad roads, no doubt. Some roads too are very good, you know, and I'm just hoping and praying that these politicians will realize that they need to, it's our fault. I always blame ourselves, because we mostly do what vote them into power, and they do whatever they like. They do whatever they like for us. So I'm just hoping and praying that we are going to make the right choice, a good choice that will come and do something better for us. Because honestly, these type of roads, you know, this area is developed. Like I showed you, I think there are a lot of people living here. When you look at the buildings, so why is it that the government is not doing this? Yes, but this is what we have, and I will tell you, please, try and understand us. Try and understand that this is what we have, and we are, like, when you're coming in, know that this is what we have. Bear with us and don't complain too much, because sometimes some of us even do complain. It has become a norm. But one thing that you cannot take away from Africa is the peace. One thing that you, so if you want your peace of mind, honestly, try coming here and learning gradually and doing what, understanding us as a people. It is not a good thing. Just look at this road. It is not a good thing at all, but what can we do? It is the government that is supposed to do this, but they are not doing it. That's a problem. Yes. That is one of the problems. A child crying like yes, crying. Okay, so my next point is going to be you being a foreigner coming into Africa, because you don't understand any local dialects. And when you come, it is obvious, like, the way you walk, your everything clearly shows that you are not from here. So when you approach any person that you want to buy something from them, you know. And with your accent alone, they can tell. With your accent alone, they can tell. And trust me, they are going to overprice stuffs for you. They are going to overprice things for you. It's not a joke. So one advice that I will give you is to all the time bargain with them. Like, bargain. This is Africa. Bargain. Everything that they tell you, this is this price, this is that price, this is this price, this is that price. Bargain with them. Bargain. And also, before you come, try learning one or two language, like the local dialect. Make sure you learn one or two phrases that you can use to greet, buy stuff from people. And I think with that, it will be difficult for people to cheat you. You understand? It will be difficult for people to cheat you. So I will advise you do something like that. And learn some few phrases, and that will even help you to mingle up with the people easily. So this is another point that I'm going to give you. This is another point that I'm going to give you. Yes. And my last point is going to be bribery and corruption. Bribery and corruption is something that I will not lie. It's in Africa. And I've heard someone like Steve Harvey talk about he coming to Africa and people robbing him. I've heard about Steve Harvey talking about he coming to Africa, or I think Ghana and South Africa. He being stopped by the police, and he just gives them $100 and he's good. Yes, $100 is honestly speaking, $100 is a lot of money. In Ghana, for instance, is a lot of money. In Africa in general, $100 is a lot of money. And you giving that money to a police officer, trust me, it's too much. We don't pay. We give them money though, but hey, we don't pay that amount. It's too much. Yeah, it's too much. So bribery and corruption is here. You just have to understand the way things go in Africa, and I think you are going to be comfortable. But if you don't understand the way things go, and you start to complain about, it's something that we all don't like it, honestly. We all don't like it and we always complain about it, but what can you do? The police is like the authority. So if you don't give it to them, they are going to frustrate you. So what are you going to do? Hey, just give them and just go. Yes, it's just something small for the boys. That's what they say, something small for the boys. And it's not just the police. There are some people who have actually gone to some government institutions to do something to help, maybe come and create jobs, build something for the community or in Africa, and they get frustrated by these government officials to pay something before they help them facilitate whatever they are coming here to do. And that is very, very bad. This is one thing that I hate a lot, but it's something that is going on. I've heard a lot of people complain about it. It's very, very bad. But my problem is, if we get frustrated by these things, and these other people, that's like we all know them, the Chinese, the Europeans, the Indians, they come and they pay these monies and they get these opportunities. It hurts me a lot. It hurts me a lot. So honestly, I will say that please don't let us look at the frustrations that you go through, but the focus, what you come here to do, is very, very important for the youth of Africa, because we need these jobs. We need them. Because we need these jobs, and we really need it. Like, we need it, like, we need these jobs, honestly. So please, when you come here and you are being frustrated, one thing that you should understand is the African politician understands just one language. And if you understand that language, everything that you do in Africa is going to go on smoothly for you. So please, don't be frustrated. You are doing this to help the youth, and we are asking that, please and please again, that's why I'm prompting you and I'm letting you know this, because I've heard a lot of people complain about it, and I'm hoping that people are not going to get frustrated, but rather they are going to be able to get the opportunity to do what is right and what they are supposed to do for us, the African youth. If you're coming here to invest and they are frustrating you, please and please again, I know it's very difficult, but focus for us. Thank you. So please, thank you so much for, I'm picking a motor back to where I came from. So I thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to like and share. Bye-bye.